Good day. If you're familiar with the 900 MHz band TBS Crossfire system, you probably know what this is. It's the TBS Immortal T antenna, which has become the standard for most folks running the TBS Crossfire system. Today, I'm going to show you an alternative, which may in fact replace the Immortal T antenna as the standard for the Crossfire 900 MHz system. It's the Video Aerial Systems, or VAS XFire Pro antenna. I'll compare the XFire Pro antenna with the Immortal T antenna by looking at the specs of each. I'll also conduct a basic static performance test of the XFire Pro versus the Immortal T, followed by comparison test flights to help you decide which antenna may be the right one for you. So if you're ready to see possibly the next gold standard for the 900 MHz band antenna, give the video a thumbs up below, make sure to share it with your friends, and subscribe to your TMac FPV channel, your home for your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing stuff.
These are the manufacturer's statements and specs on both the TBS Crossfire Immortal T and the VAS XFire Pro. I've highlighted in yellow the significant features of the XFire Pro which make it stand out from the Immortal T. One of those features is that it comes in two different types. The semi-rigid form over here in black on the left, and also what VAS describes as the ultra-flex version over here on the right, which adds even more durability. We'll do some real-world measurements and weigh-ins here next, but before we do, another important feature of the XFire Pro is that it is cross-polarized in design to eliminate polarization loss. I'm not going to get into what that is because Alex Grieve, Mr. VAS himself, also known as IB Crazy, has already done a video explaining that, which you can check out through a link in this video's description below. It's designed also to have no nulls, which are areas with very little to no signal propagation, such as with the Immortal T if one of the ends of the antenna is pointing directly at your transmitter during a flight maneuver of your quad. So with the XFire Pro, you don't have to worry about that. Of course, we're going to test those claims here shortly through both a basic static test and also test flights to see what real-world results we come up with. First, let's take a look at the real-world measurements and weigh both antenna. Here are the measurements for each. The TBS Crossfire Immortal T antenna comes in at 146 millimeters with a cable length of about 75 millimeters. The VAS XFire Pro does come in at less than half the size at 61 millimeters with a cable length of about 114 millimeters. You can get the Immortal T extended version with a cable length of 120 millimeters. Now let's weigh them in.
Right, it's weighing time. Immortal T comes in at 3 grams. XFire Pro comes in at 1 gram.
Here's how we have the Immortal T antenna mounted to our Rattler, and this is usually the way to mount it on one of the quad's arms using two zip ties, keeping the ends of the antenna as far away as possible from the carbon fiber. It's nearly impossible to mount this antenna vertically on a micro quad or even a mini quad, but it can be done in some cases. Anyway, this is the way I've got it mounted on the Rattler, and in this configuration, I'm going to do a very basic, not very scientific, static field test of the link quality we obtain with the Immortal T antenna. If you're not familiar with the phrase link quality, make sure to check out this video on TBS Crossfire Telemetry. I'm then going to swap out the Immortal T for the VAS XFire Pro, show you how I'm going to mount it, and then do the same basic static test with the XFire Pro to see what type of link quality we get with it. I'll finish with flight test comparisons of both antenna. All right, the way I've got this little experiment set up is I've got two tripods, one over here by my quadiction gate with a transmitter on it, and the TBS Crossfire Diamond antenna parallel to the Immortal T antenna on the quadcopter over by the orange race gate, which is about 50 yards away. Here we've got the Immortal T antenna parallel to the Diamond antenna on the transmitter. And we're going to start out that way, and we're going to look at the link quality in the OSD. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to rotate the quadcopter so that the antenna, the Immortal T antenna, points directly at the Diamond antenna on the transmitter and see if there's any change in the link quality. From there, I'm going to rotate the quadcopter so that the Immortal T antenna is perpendicular to the ground and see if there's any change in the link quality in the OSD with that orientation. We're then going to repeat the same process with the XFire Pro and compare the results for both. All right, we're starting off with the Immortal T antenna parallel to the Diamond antenna on the transmitter, and we're going to rotate it slowly until it points directly at the diamond antenna on the transmitter to see if anything changes with the link quality in the OSD. Okay, at this point, it's pointing directly at the diamond antenna on the transmitter, which is parallel to the ground. We're now going to rotate the quadcopter so the Immortal T antenna is perpendicular to the ground to see if we notice any change in the link quality in that orientation when the diamond antenna is parallel to the ground. All right, the Immortal T antenna is now directly perpendicular to the ground, whereas the diamond antenna is parallel to the ground. Rotate it back, pointing directly at the diamond antenna, and parallel to the diamond antenna. And we'll do the same process with the VAS XFire Pro.
Now I'm going to replace the Immortal T antenna with the VAS XFire Pro antenna. Since by its design, both being cross-polarized to eliminate polarization loss and also with no nulls, I'm able to position it on the quad wherever I want. I could actually mount it vertically on the quadcopter using one of these two mounting holes and a zip tie. I could actually zip tie it to the VTX antenna, but instead, it's almost like this XFire Pro was specifically designed for the Rattler frame, because what I'm going to do is install it on the Rattler frame here using these two mounting holes and align them directly with these two standoff mounting screws for a perfect fit. Then I'll just run the cable through and attach it to the receiver inside. So let's go ahead and do that. Look at that, perfect fit. Then I'll just run the cable through here and attach it to the receiver inside.
All right, now that we've got the XFire Pro installed on the Rattler, we're going to use the same process with it that we did with the Immortal T antenna, where we start off with the XFire Pro parallel to the TBS Crossfire diamond antenna. We're going to rotate it slowly so that one end of the antenna is pointing directly at the diamond, and then we're going to rotate the quad so that the XFire Pro antenna is perpendicular to the ground. Then we're going to rotate it back and make it parallel again to the diamond antenna, and we'll see what happens to the link quality.
So that's the VAS XFire Pro antenna compared with the TBS Crossfire Immortal T antenna. Which one do you like best? Make sure to let me know in the comments section below. For more FPV fun stuff, make sure to subscribe, hit that notification bell, and to start your journey to better FPV fun, head on over to the TMacFPV.com website for more free resources and to check out the Fast Track FPV course, your clear flight path to FPV fun. Thanks for your time. I'll see you next video. Clear skies, friend.